Hi everyone, I'm Emily Teague. Today alongside me is my best friend, roommate, and wildly talented fine art photographer, Brandy Nicole. We live together in Brooklyn, New York, but we are currently working out of Cape Town in South Africa and excited to share a little bit of its beauty today. Along with photographing others, Brandy also does incredible self-portraiture and has also inspired me to lean more out of my comfort zone and start exploring self-portraiture as well.
I've been taking self-portraits since I got my first digital camera in the early 2000s, and since we first became roommates 4 years ago, we've been taking them together. I love taking self-portraits because it's the ultimate form of creativity and self-expression. We are so excited to share with you our process to create and collaborate together because we find it really levels up our production and always results in more growth.
So today we're going to take you through our entire creative process from dreaming up an idea and story into planning and producing that idea. We'll also talk a bit about our equipment, our lighting, what settings we're using, and also a look inside about how we're approaching this photo shoot as we go. In doing these self-portraits together, we really treat it as time to just play and explore new ideas. So that's a lot of what we'll be showing today too.
So today we've just finished hair and makeup and have done a lot of prep work on our latest collaboration together called Inspiration Hunting. So Emily, tell them a little bit about how we came up with this idea.
So Brandy and I have pretty different aesthetics. Brandy leans towards kind of whimsical white colors. I lean a little bit darker, but we get inspired by the same things. And so oftentimes we'll look at images and we'll just take it in a different direction. And so with this, we kind of started playing with the idea of how can we represent where we're at in our life right now? And that led us to the concept of inspiration hunting. So the idea for this photo shoot is basically we are running away from reality and going into our creative dreamland. And we've found a few different ways to do this, starting with the location. Do you want to talk a little bit about that, Brandy?
Yes, so actually our location is this magical sandy place that we found here in Cape Town that a friend actually showed us. And we just happened upon it a couple weeks ago and decided this is absolutely like a part of our dreamlands and thought that this would be a perfect backdrop for our idea.
So knowing what the location looked like and knowing a little bit of the story, we then started putting together more details of what the entire concept would look like. So we started thinking about hair and makeup and wardrobe, and then we found our hair and makeup artist Rain and our stylist Tanlin, and we came to them with a few different words kind of to describe what we wanted, as well as a Pinterest mood board, just to get everyone on the same team as far as what we're looking for. So some of those words were warm, glowing, youthful, romantic, curious, soft, subtle, playful, nostalgic, dreamy, delicate, feminine, utopia, ethereal, innocent, artistic, chasing something with passion, living in the moment, star sisters, and honey. And that is a lot of words, but that's essentially a word journey. And so every time I do a photo shoot, I come up with a word journey. But for this one, because it's a collaboration between Brandy and I together, we came up with these words back and forth. And that really helped us also define the story for each other. Because not only is it hard to tell your team, but when you're sharing a concept and really building it together, you have to be on the same page.
So from our word journeys, we really like to make a Pinterest board specifically because it really aligns our vision for our shoots. And it also just makes sure everybody on our team is on the same page in terms of the aesthetics and the vibe for the shoot. So, for example, our Pinterest board for Inspiration Hunting is this very candid, casual, beautiful feminine moments. We are kind of like in a bohemian summer. We have a picnic situation going on. It's just this really fun, like two best friends kind of on this like inspiration hunt for whatever project is next on their list.
And similar to word journeys where we're going back and forth, we're doing the same thing with Pinterest. So maybe I'll add an image that I think fits the vibe, and then Brandy will find an image and she'll add that in, and we start building on top of each other's ideas. We've found this is the easiest way for two artists to come together and collaborate, because there definitely are challenges to having two artists with unique ideas and over a decade each of experience doing what they think is the right way to do something. Brandy, do you want to talk about any of those challenges that we faced as we were doing this and as we always face through collaboration? Because collaboration is never easy, but it is beautiful, right?
Absolutely. I think that is so important to talk about. When you have two kind of creative directors coming at a collaboration, and that's exactly what this is today, is both of us coming together on a story, right? And I can have a very clear idea of a photo that I have in mind for us. And I obviously want Emily's perspective and her like input to kind of elevate that initial idea into something even greater, because that is how collaboration is, this magical thing. It's one thing if you're just like bossing people around. It's another if you're kind of like organically growing an idea into something even cooler.
And I think with collaboration, we're really taking the best parts of ourselves and then combining them together. So every time we do one of these collaborations, I'm learning from Brandy. I hope she's learning from me. And I think it's a really beautiful process.
Exactly. And on the same kind of wavelength with our team, our hair and makeup artists, our stylists, we're also collaborating with them, right? So something to keep in mind is if you have a specific vision of something that you would like and you are collaborating with a makeup artist, you have to kind of make sure that they are in control of their artistry as well, because otherwise it's not really a collaboration. It's you telling somebody what you would like them to do, which is a little bit different. So for this particular one, we gave our mood board to our team and was like, what do you think? Let's work together and make something all together.
I think every team member we have is always elevating our work as well, and we really trust them to do that. So we might come to them with the key concept and exactly what we think we want, but every time we've ever done this, they always take it and make it better because they're artists themselves. For this photo shoot, we also knew that we wanted props to really add to the storytelling elements. And Brandy, you often source a lot of props for your photo shoots. Do you want to talk a little bit about that process of how we source props for this photo shoot?
Absolutely. So we are here in South Africa. It has the most incredible flowers. I always love to incorporate flowers because it's just this beautiful feminine element that I think can really elevate a photo. So we went to the flower market and we found some beautiful dried protea and some pampas grass and things that I think could really lend to the aesthetics of the photo shoot. And also we ended up going to a fabric store that just completely inspired us. We ended up grabbing fabrics that we can use for our picnic, for shooting through, and really just kind of getting all sorts of things that we could kind of get creative with on set.
There's also a cool moment when we were at the fabric store. We were looking at Chantilly lace, and there's an area on it called the eyelashes, right?
Yes, yes. Brandy. If you cut it in a very specific way, it's this beautiful like eyelash detail of the lace that you can have on the edge. And even just hearing the woman that was cutting this fabric explain that to us was so beautiful and inspiring. And now we're definitely going to be incorporating that into our photo shoot today.
We have a few ideas for an added look that includes eyelashes and covering the eyes, so it's good that even when we're collecting resources, we're still getting inspired for ideas as we're doing that too.
Exactly.
Last thing to mention is our lighting. So we have a plan, and we also like to go away from plans and experiment when we're on set, but it's always really nice to have an idea of what we want to do. So for our first look, it's wearing these more like casual, we're kind of going from casual to magical as we're slipping into this dreamland in the story. So we're gonna start out just using natural hard light. I think it's gonna be about 3-4 o'clock when we get there. So the sun is still pretty high up because it's summertime in Cape Town right now. So we're gonna have some nice hard lighting and we'll lean into that. And then as our sun starts going down and starts going behind the hill and we get some more even light, that's when we're gonna bring out our strobe and start mixing ambient with artificial and kind of getting this really dreamy, feathery look. So Brandy, do you wanna talk about what we're packing for today?
So today we are bringing our Ellen Chrome 5 with a modifier. I have my camera, I have a tripod for my phone to get behind the scenes. I have extra SD cards and batteries. I have the remote for our Ellen Chrome 5 as well as a remote for my camera. I also have extra clips and scissors and ribbons and things that we might need and everything our stylist brought.
So let's see how it goes. Okay, so we're here at our first location, and the concept here is we're kind of in our regular clothes and we're escaping reality. So we're running up this hill, I'm reaching back to grab Brandy, she is chasing after me, and we're just running into our creative world here. Brandy, do you want to talk a little bit about how we're setting everything up?
Yes, so with self-portraits, I really love to use my tripod, usually at a low angle as well, and also interval timer. I think this is one of those features that makes self-portraits so, so easy because you can set it up to take a certain amount of photos. Right now we're doing 30 photos. After 10 seconds, I'll hit that shutter button. 10 seconds will go, and then it will take 30 photos every like half second. And you can actually customize all of those variables so that your self-portraits are exactly perfect for what you need. So we have it set up on interval timer. We have settings 1/100 right now, F5 and ISO 100. I assume they'll kind of change throughout the day, but that's where we're starting.
And last thing to say is we're focusing just kind of on that bush right there. So we're making sure to stay within that plane of focus. Let's see how it goes.
See how it goes.
So we made it to the top of the hill, we changed looks, and the idea up here is we are breathing in creativity, we are letting go, we're going to be running down this hill. The only issue is our light keeps changing dramatically every few seconds.
So the way I actually combat this with self-portraiture is to actually set my ISO to auto ISO. So right now our settings are F11, 1 over 125, and auto ISO. And this is going to help us keep track of that sun changing and still give us that same aesthetic that we want.
So we just did a couple shots at the top of the hill. Now we're gonna try running down and hopefully our sun will stay behind this cloud. But if not, again, we're on auto ISO, so we'll be okay. Let's try it out.
So here we are at our last look. We're still at this magical location. We're at our little dreamy picnic here with flowers, and our settings are still the same because we're still at this magical location, but we are actually doing something a little different with lighting this time.
So we took our Ellen Chrome 5 and we were gonna pair it with a 39-inch modifier, but at the moment it was very, very windy and we did not want to do that to our assistant Josh. So we actually had him hold it bare bulb just right behind us, and it gave us this really nice highlight behind that was going through the parasol, was lighting up our hair, and just kind of adding to this overall dreamy wonderland that we've created. So I think we're super happy with the photos, excited to review them tonight. Thank you for sticking around with us, and if you guys have any questions, make sure to ask in the comment section below. Say hi to Brandy, and we appreciate having you guys with us. See you next time.